everyone. Today in this video, I am sharing with you how I have decorated my patio for the summer season. I have used many thrifted and budget-friendly decor pieces, so I'm excited to show you how it has come together in a fun and homey style. So, I used to decorate in the last couple years in the patio out here in more of a neutral color scheme. This year, I decided to go with a little bit more pop of color. It's kind of a patriotic theme, honestly. It wasn't planned to be that way, but it kind of turned out that way. So I'm gonna walk you through the process of how I have made up our little deck slash patio. First of all, you gotta always sweep off the deck and patio, get all the spring leaves and dirt and dust and dog hair off of the patio deck area. And it is right off of our kitchen, so I love to have it, the door open sometimes, and just, I wanted it to be an extension of our home, really. So that's what my goal was for this space. Okay, so after I finished sweeping, I did string some new lights. My old lights were broken. They had been up all winter long, and I think the snow and other things just made them die. So I got some good quality LED lights, which will hopefully last me longer, from our local hardware store. And then I just restrung them on our railing, and I love having those lights on in the evening. It's just so cozy and inviting to look out of the kitchen window and door and sit out here in the evenings enjoying that light. All right, and then the next thing was this new rug. I am in love with this rug. I got it last season, end of summer into fall, from walmart.com. I think it's good to shop after the seasons, honestly. You save lots of money. It was $25, a 5x7 mainstay rug. I love the blue and cream slash white color, and I just think that is where the pop of color really pops in for me and adds that coziness and cohesiveness. A rug just really honestly makes a space warm and inviting. So I got the rug for $25, like I said, which is really a great price, and from walmart.com. I'll try to link it if I can find it. It might not be in stock anymore since I got it last season. And then after the rug, I started putting out some of my furniture I already had. This space is not big enough for a patio table, so it's more just as a seating, cozy area. So I have this old wicker chair that I found at a garage sale several seasons back for $20. I used that, put a little thrifted pillow on it that thankfully was also in the blue and white color scheme. And then I repainted this black, well, it was bronze colored metal stool that was thrifted again, of course. And I just had used it as like a bronze color in the past. I know it's not really outdoor furniture either, but it works really well as a side table. It matches well with the black legs of our wicker chair. So I just thought that would tie in really well and be a nice little side table. As you can see, to put a plant on that I got from our local greenhouse, along with our little patriotic square decor piece that I have as well. And so that just tied in over in this corner. And then I just started putting out my plants that I've gotten. And I have a lot of terracotta planters that I've found at garage sales and collected over time that I've used and planted flowers in, to just add color and life and vibrancy to this space. And then crates, of course, are another added feature that I put on my patio here this year. I use crates in my home. If you haven't watched my 5 Ways to Decorate in a Farmhouse Style, crates is one of those ways. And indoors, outdoors, they are a great way to add texture, height, dimension to any space. So I got those crates, of course, throughout the years, and used those to decorate as well. And then I did not have 2 chairs for this space. I was really disappointed. I couldn't find one. I've been searching Facebook Marketplace for weeks now to find some patio chairs, some furniture, or something else to add to this space. And so I just had put a old folding chair out with like that mesh pattern on it. which I really did not like at all, but I needed another seat for us to sit out on, and so I put that there for now. But then that night, like I typically do, I was looking on Facebook Marketplace, and I came across this lovely wicker chair with, as you can see, a very beat up orange cushion. And so I measured the cushion and went and ordered right away from Walmart as well. This is not sponsored, by the way, from Walmart. It's just that's where I found the best prices so far. So I found a red cushion, and that's where the patriotic theme kind of comes in to go on that wicker chair. And I think the space is going to come together really well, especially with a new cushion. I think that'll just add that nice vibrant pop of red, which I typically don't decorate with, but I think that'll be a fun touch. So I got the chair anyways, back to that, for $15 on Facebook Marketplace. And then the cushion I found on Walmart, like $26. So about $45 for the chair, which wicker furniture is usually super expensive for a patio. So I was really blessed to find that, and so excited to find that as well. And then I found a fern and used another crate to kind of hide the eyesore that's going on over in the corner of our patio area. It's just where like the meter is and some other things, just outlets are, it's just how it's set up. So I wanted to kind of disguise that area. So a big fern was nice to have, and it does hang. I don't know if I'm going to hang it or not, but for now it's just sitting on another crate I have. So that is how I have decorated. Very simple, very rustic, very budget friendly. And these are all things that I've really just collected over time, things I found for a reasonable rate to make my space truly a continuation of my home to the outdoors. I'm excited to spend time out here with our little girl, and maybe when we can have friends over, have friends out here, it should be such a lovely space to enjoy. So I hope this encourages you to find some things around your house to decorate with, and to search Thrifty, Facebook Marketplace, just find some things that will work for your space. But if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, because then I know you like these videos. And if you haven't hit that red subscribe button, you like these type of videos, like simple living, motherhood, homemaking, then I think you should hit that button, because it really shows that you enjoy these types of videos. So anyways, I hope you are having a blessed and wonderful day, and I look forward to talking with you in my next video at the end of the week. All right, love you guys. Bye.